So when Pine Hills was founded, it was founded where the community didn't look the way it does now. The community has changed, right? So we had many, many cities that were formed out of here, many areas. So Dr. Phillips grew from out of here. People moved out of here. We have Winter Garden, Winter Park, different areas that formed outside of here because they used to live here. And when Lockheed, that's now Lockheed Martin, opened up, they moved for jobs to get closer to where the jobs were. And then we had the community that was changing. Different people were moving here from up north and from different parts of the country here, right? And it took a turn when our community started facing poverty and the different things that help homelessness to contribute to blight. And of course, you know what blight leads to. But I'm hopeful. I'm very hopeful. I'm very hopeful because as the founder of a nonprofit organization, United Foundation of Central Florida, that has worked in this community for 10 years, we've helped to improve and change those numbers for the better. Evans High School graduation rate was a little over 50% almost 10 years ago. We're at 90% today. And definitely one of the individuals that will help to take credit for that as having the largest after-school program in Evans High School. So there's a lot that's going on that's good here that we need to talk about. And we need to push that a little bit more because the focus is always on the negative. We're not talking about the students that have gone off to Princeton, full ride from my program, Cornell University, Harvard, right? FAMU, doing exceptionally well. I have the track record and the records to prove it, that this has been done here. And there are great groups that are doing things here outside of United Foundation of Central Florida, Future Leaders United. So we need to push those a little bit more. We need to bring resources behind those a little bit more. Because when we did our forum recently, heard a lot of things from our community members about how they're feeling and what we could possibly do to help with what's going on around here. We provided towards the food insecurities for over 2.5 years. And I'll be honest with you, that started right here at this center. Right here at this center, since 2015, we've been tackling food insecurities. That's one problem I'll talk to you about first. And we started in 2015, just going out to the different areas that we knew suffered from food insecurities. Started back in 2015. Fast forward to 2020, where we are today, because I partnered with several senators and individuals doing food drives. And I remember trying to partner, and that didn't work, right? So I called my friends. You can always call on your friends. And my friends said yes. I asked the Pine Hills Community Center if I could do a food drive here, because the need came from here. I got the phone call that there's a need from our parents, Head Start here, that we're having difficulty with food. I called my friends and said, "Hey, listen, let's do a food drive." It was close to the 4th of July, the holidays coming up. Let's do something for this community, right? And I thought it was one time. That was not the case. They asked me how many families. I said about 300. Well, I'll tell you, that day, I remember it like it was yesterday. Almost 3 years ago, we had over 600 families show up here. So I didn't know what I was saying, but I said, "See you guys next week." And I'll tell you, yes, see you next week. And that led to over 3 years of providing for this community. Why did I tell you that story? I told you that story because I saw everyone on that line. I saw people that had single family homes, two-parent homes, full family homes, laid off, didn't have an opportunity to find a job, couldn't find a job. Different things, different dynamics of people were on that line. And I told you that story because I want people to understand that situations take us through different things. It doesn't mean that individuals are not trying. But I'm a firm believer that you should try and help yourself, right? And when I say try to help yourself, there are resources that are talked about every single day that are out there. Are we not doing a good job putting it out there? Or can't we get the individuals to come out and hear about the resources, right? So Pine Hills is a neighborhood that resources are in. We need more. We need more resources. But I also feel that people don't come out enough to hear about those resources that can help them to come out of the situation that they are. And I know there are rough situations out there. There's homelessness. It's in our Orange County public schools. It's everywhere, right? We have hard times that people are facing. We have health issues. But we're willing to work with them. We talk about resources that are there every single day. But I also think that we can do a better job of pushing it out there for the people that really need it. We don't want to do a handout. We want to do a hand up so that we can help our community thrive.